We also have folks on Facebook. So I always like to start off with, I think I know several people in here tonight, but let's see if you don't mind telling me where you're from and how much you've lost, or you can put it in the chat window. If you want to put that on Facebook, that's great. About 20-second delay. And we will get started with a grocery store tour tonight, continuing at Kroger. Anybody tell me where they're from or how much weight they've lost? Anybody? How much weight you've all lost? Where y'all from? I have some familiar faces. Or if you're brand new on Shibboleth, all right, Valerie, 14 pounds, Indiana. Great, Valerie, thanks. 14 pounds from Indiana. Anybody else? Catherine on Facebook, Dalton, Georgia. All right, glad to have Dalton, Georgia on board. Greenwood, Pam, that's where I live, Greenwood, Indiana. So Cartersville, Georgia, 9.2 down. Awesome, Lori. Good job. Kathy is from Michigan. She's lost 50 pounds. She's on Facebook. Awesome, Kathy. Good job. Got another. All right. Same Kathy. I thought I had two Kathy. Same Kathy. All right. Anybody else? Jennifer from Nacogdoches. That's a long word to spell, isn't it, Jennifer? Nacogdoches. Texas, not sure, weighing tomorrow. Happy to be here tonight. Awesome. Jennifer's been coming to the classes and very faithful. And that's awesome, Jennifer. And let's see anybody else tonight. All right. Well, we'll probably have a lot more hop in tonight as we get started. And I'll just start with the usual introduction. So I am Jim, and that is me. I lost 35 pounds 10 years ago, eating the Shibboleth way, and continue to maintain my weight loss. So because I live a lifestyle, and that's the most important thing, is you have to live a lifestyle that you can live with. I love the fact that I can have holidays, woohoo, and I can have, you know, perfect days and holidays and all sorts of things. So I love the lifestyle, and I would encourage you that, I mean, just learn what you like to eat and always try something new. So I did something a little bit different tonight. It was an omelet that was inspired by a restaurant that I went to about a month ago. And I thought, I think I could make a Shibboleth version of that. So I had an omelet tonight with a little bit of pork shoulder in it. And of course, you have to watch your protein portion. For guys, you want to limit it around 6 to 8 ounces or so. Ladies, 2 to 8 ounces, really more like 2 to 6, ladies. But so you have to watch your protein, but I had that tonight. We took the pork shoulder and fried it up just a little bit and just in its own juice in the pan, and then put a little bit, put an egg in there and made an omelet with it and some mushroom, which is a category 2, and a little bit of onion, which is the condiment. So I had a fatty protein and I had some mushroom, fibrous carb, I already say that. And I had a piece of my fibrous carb toast. So I had a protein plus fat plus a fibrous carb. So it was super yummy tonight, very tasty. All right, Diane from Ackworth lost 18 pounds since January 4th. Great job, okay. Michelle says, my Zoom link is not working. I don't know if I can throw that in there for you real quickly. I tell you what, go out to, Michelle, just go out to the website real quickly. And if you'll just go out to the website, and let me open up an extra page here for you. If you just go out to the website, click on online webinars, and you should be able to click right here, register right there, and go watch that online, Michelle. So that'll probably help you out. So I assume it's working. I got folks in the Zoom room tonight, so I assume it's working here tonight as well. Also, I told you all, if you were here last night, that I would get an email out to you from last night, and that is in the works right now. I'm the newest member of the group, so I'm learning my way around everything here at Shibboleth Online, and so just got a lot of irons in the fire right now. So I'm working on that. The email's ready. We're just going to make a few final tweaks. Travis and I talked about it today, and just trying to get everything set up. So don't worry, I will also put together an email of tonight's class So if you missed anything in tonight's class, don't freak out. If you register in the Zoom room, you can get that. If you're not a member of Shibboleth and you're wondering, what is this all about? You're welcome to join us tonight. If you register, come into Zoom room, then you'll get an email tomorrow. And I've got a little special offer for you if you're not a member of Shibboleth that you might want to check out. So that is there. So for everybody in the Zoom room who's registered, I'll get that email out. Maybe tomorrow, maybe Thursday, by the end of the week. Once I get into stride, it'll all be going. But I'm also a pastor, so usually Wednesday is almost all day church day because I'm for the last almost year, I've been doing a pretty in-depth look at prophecy and things like that. And I've got I'm teaching through the book of Zechariah right now. And I've done very small prep right now. I got a lot of prep to do before tomorrow night. So Wednesdays are kind of church day for me. So I won't get to do a whole lot with Shibboleth, but I will Thursday I'll be back doing some things. So hopefully we'll get that out to you. All right, let's get this show on the road. I want to keep these about 30, 45 minutes. So y'all don't get tired of me too fast. And here we go. So tonight, oh, by the way, if you want alert when I'm going to be on, you can text the word grocery tour to 31996. All right, so tonight our topic is going to be meal replacements at Kroger. Now that's covered a little bit in the fast track class. So again, if you're new to Shibboleth, the first place you need to go to is to the fast track. So when you go in, click on dashboard and you will see that. I just want to show everybody, if you're brand new to Shibboleth, click on fast track. That's where you want to start. Kim will walk with you through and you'll get a good grounding in the program, go through all 7 laps. Take the quiz, pass the quiz, earn your badge, get your badge down here and all that stuff. Where's down there is the badge. There you go. So earn the badge and get rocking and rolling with that. Okay. So just letting you know about fast track. All right. So we're going to start tonight with frozen entrees. And what I want you to know is these are at Kroger frozen entrees. Because we have different grocery stores I'm going to do on different weeks. This week is just Kroger week. Where am I at there? I just want to show you, this is just a smattering of all the meal replacements we have here on Shibboleth. All the meal replacements, okay? So what I have combed through this entire list and tried to find the ones that at least the Kroger website, see, I'm only down to the M's, y'all. So I'm trying to find the entire things at Kroger that we could do. One other thing I want to show you is you'll notice that I said -3 here and the website continues to go. It says -3. These are our fastest fat burning entrees. There is no way I'm going to get through every frozen entree that's available at Kroger tonight in the next 30 to 45 minutes. So what I'm focusing on are the fastest fat burners according to our weight loss meter on Shibboleth. So on Shibboleth, a -3 is the fastest. Lots of reasons that's been deemed the fastest, whatever foods are in that category. Then there's -2. Then there's -1. All those right there, -1, -2, and -3 are the killers. Those are, if you're wanting to lock it down, as Travis said, and rip off the knob, then you want to use those -3s, -2, -1s. Zeros, they're not gonna hurt you, not gonna help you, but they're okay. We get 1s, 2s, and 3s, you know, those are gonna slow down your weight loss. I would recommend, honestly, if you're in weight loss mode, I wouldn't personally dabble with the 1s, 2s, and 3s unless you're in more of a maintenance mode. So I just want you to know, so tonight we're really going to be confining this class to -3, -2, and -1s. And what we're going to look at is hopefully we're going to get through frozen entrees and shakes, bars, and some mixes that you can find at Kroger. We're not talking about all the other grocery stores. We're not talking about Vitamin Shoppe, GNC, and everything you can buy at Shibboleth. And again, anybody's watching this has never been on Shibboleth. We are not a product-based program. You don't have to buy anything from us. We are a grocery store-based program. So we want to educate and empower you about food. Now, we do have stuff you can buy if you want, but where you're not required to buy any products from us. But what I want to do is I want to take you down the Kroger store. So tonight we're at Kroger, and we are going to see what meal replacements they have that are a negative three. So let's go out to the Kroger website. Right here, we're at the Kroger website. Now, I'm going to start off with a name that y'all are probably very familiar with, and that's Atkins. But not every Atkins thing is a shibboleth negative three. The only Atkins one that's a negative three is this bacon cheddar cauliflower bites. Bacon cheddar cauliflower bites is a negative three here on the Atkins. So now, not other Atkins are approved, but this is the fastest one on that. I want to show you another one tonight that is really good. I don't know if you've tried these, but they're made by Flapjack. You can do any flavor. I love these guys right here. These are Mighty Muffins, and these are super yummy. They are like you go to the, you know, if you go to a Panera Bread and you buy the big muffin, well, they're not, maybe not that big, but it's a pretty good size muffin. And what you do is I shake it up a little bit and then put about, I think it's a quarter cup of cold water in it, and then stir it around, put it on the microwave for about 50 seconds. And I run the knife around the edge, flip it up, and out pops a nice hot piping muffin. So that's really what I love there. So if you, by the way, if anybody here has tried this, please put it in chat. If you've tried a Mighty Muffin, has anybody, while I'm going to the next one, tried it? And if so, did you like it? If you liked it or tried it, let me know if you've tried it. Anybody tried that? All right. So, okay, good. Got some folks that said, love the blueberry one. And I added a few blueberries. Yes, I always add a little bit of, just a little bit of fat-free Ready Whip with mine. So good. So there you go. Pam said she tried them today. Hope you liked them. They're not too bad. I think they're pretty good. And it's quick. And let me, I made waffles with them. Oh, okay. Interesting. And we're going to look at a waffle mix that is approved. Let me say something real quickly too, before I go any further. The things we're talking about tonight are not like what we want you to live on at Shibboleth. We certainly want you to live on whole foods. Like last night, if you were on my tour, we did chicken breast, turkey breast. We want fish. We want you to live on those things, vegetables. But the reason we allow these things is it's sometimes just life happens and you got to make something quick, or you got to throw something in the microwave because you just don't have time. So we would rather you eat something that's going to keep the fat bus parked and keep you in efficient fat burn than for you to say, oh, I don't have time to cook a meal, and you grab something trashy out of the refrigerator. Okay. So, they are in Kroger's. Pam asked me where. I am not really sure. Yeah, let me show you something though real quickly for those who are watching. And this is something you might want to look at real quickly. Let's see if I can pull this up here. I was going to show you my phone. And is my phone not screencasting? Let me check that out. I've got people texting tonight, and that may be my problem. I was going to show you on my phone. What you want to do is get you the Kroger app, and let's see if we can get that to pull back up. There we go. Get you the Kroger app if you shop at Kroger. So here's my Kroger app, and here's something you may or may not know about the Kroger app here on the phone. It's a little advertisement. Up here at the top, you can hit search for products, and I'll click Mighty Muffins. Okay. I can't type and talk. And I want to show you something. I've used this at Kroger a lot. If you are at Kroger, one thing you might notice is a lot of times they will tell you, right here, I clicked on it. Now this is my local store, but if you'll see there, it says aisle 11, breakfast. So this is really helpful. If you're at Kroger, Walmart will do the same thing on the Walmart app. So if you're at one of these places like Kroger, you maybe think about using that app, because that will help you find things. There's been lots of times my wife sends me on an errand at Kroger, and I'll be honest, I know Kroger really well. I've done grocery store tours there. But sometimes it's like, where do I find that? So I'll just pull up the app and say, oh, it's on aisle whatever. Okay. So my Kroger, they're across in the oatmeal. That's probably where they're at. They're usually tend to be over in the breakfast area a lot of times as well. Okay, let me keep moving here. Here is another one here at Kroger. As far as lunch, supper would be the Healthy Choice Grilled Chicken and Broccoli Alfredo. Again, this is a -3, a top fat burner. So you want to check this one out. Look at all the veggies there. Again, a lot of times these tend to have a lot higher levels of sodium, and some people need to watch their sodium content on that. We get that. So if your doctor has you on a sodium restriction, then obviously you need to follow your doctor. This one's got 600 milligrams, but there you go. So that is another one that you can get there. Let me give you another one that you can find at Kroger. It's by Life Cuisine, and it's right here. Here's another one that you can do at Kroger. It's the Life Cuisine Tomato and Spinach Egg White Bite. So this is a breakfast item. This is a breakfast item. So again, this is something you might want to try out. Here is another brand, and there's quite a few of their things that work. Real Good Foods. Now they have these enchiladas. Now right now, we'll hit cheese in a minute, but the beef, the pork, they have a couple different flavors. This one right here, this enchilada, is a -3 on the fat burn meter as well. So take a look at that. If you say, Jim, how much? Well, just go over here to the food library, and you can look it up, click on the item and look it up, and you can see how much to eat. There we go. It hasn't loaded all my meal library up. And again, that's partly because I've been on other screens, so it's taking for a while to do it. If I was just camped out here on Shibboleth. But this just shows you, again, it's always frustrating to me when people say, there are just nothing I can eat on that program. Oh, baloney. This is one category of food, folks. Good grief. Give me a break. That's just an excuse. And you know what I tell people? I'm going to preach for a second. You can have excuses or you can have results, but you can't have both. It's bottom line. So I've seen this. I've been teaching weight loss for almost 10 years now too. And you get people coming in and they start giving me all sorts of excuses. Well, I can't do that. I can't do that. You know what? You're going to fail. Sorry. You're going to fail. I'm just being honest. I've seen it over and over and over again. So sorry, got on the wagon for a second, but I'm not going to say sorry. It's true. So, but if you wonder how much to eat, just like here, here's real enchiladas. Now, notice the cheese is a -1. Right now, I'm just showing you the -3s. But let's just take a look at that one. And so it tells us right here, 2 enchiladas. Now, remember, like I said last night, let's say that Jennifer goes to Kroger. She has these 2 enchiladas. She really likes them. Well, she can favorite those enchiladas. Okay, and so the nice thing about her favoriting the enchiladas is over here on her journal, and I'll throw you out to my journal page today. When she goes over there, she can look under favorite food. I just favorited it, and it will show up in here under favorite foods or favorite meals. So it will show up in that area. So again, there it is, real good chicken, beef. So Jennifer can go out there and look at that and say, oh yeah, that's one of my favorites. So that's a cool feature as well. And as I showed you yesterday, she could add it to her grocery list. Again, I showed you yesterday, but you can watch the Fast Track class on how to do this. She could add it to her Kroger grocery list. So when she's at the store, she's got that Kroger grocery list. So I wanted to show that one to you as well. All right. If there's any questions, let me check here on Facebook real quickly. I've got a couple of things going on at once. Polly talked about, everybody's giving some things about the Mighty Muffins. Yes, those are awesome sauce. So love Mighty Muffins. All right, so let me take you now. So those were our negative threes. Here they be. I already talked about them, and I will send these to you in class notes. So these are the ones that I found at Kroger, and that's our focus tonight. So add them there to your grocery list if you shop at Kroger a lot, and boom. Now let's go to the negative twos. So those were our fastest fat burners on the weight loss meter. Let's go to ones that just a step below them, and let's take a look at these. So here's a healthy choice, Simply Steamer chicken and vegetable stir fry. Healthy choice, Simply Steamer chicken, vegetable, and stir fry. So again, healthy choice. And remember, one thing I always tell people, just because one product works in a line doesn't mean every product works in that line. So there are some of these things in the healthy choice line that just don't work from our perspective, or they're a zero or one, two, or three, and I'm not even getting into that tonight. But if you want a great negative two, still a great fat burner, here is the chicken and vegetable stir fry. So we got chicken breast, broccoli, edamame, carrots, red peppers, onions, and a sesame soy sauce. So very nice. A little bit lower on the sodium than the last one we looked at. So that's a good one. Here's another one, the Lean Cuisine, and it is the steak portabella. So let's see right here. It is the Lean Cuisine steak portabella. So doesn't that look yummy? That's probably not real sauce. It's probably like plastic. No, I'm teasing. But a great one right there. And again, you can go out to the website and check those out. Here is another real good line and that take a look at. And that is the Real Good Bacon, Egg, and Cheddar Cheese Breakfast Sandwich. And I think that was out there. Maybe it was this one I was looking at. Here it is. Real Good Bacon, Egg, and Cheese Breakfast Sandwich. So there you can have that. Let's go back out here and take a look at, it's still loading that because I popped out of here for a minute. But again, we can take a look at that and just see how much that you're allowed to eat. So there is that one. Let's take a look at another one. And let's see, am I back on there? Okay, so we got that. This is a Kroger line. And if you were with me last night, this is like their healthy line of food. And Kroger is pretty up on all this stuff. Here is a Kroger Simple Truth ham and Swiss cheese omelet bites. So right here it is. Uncured ham and Swiss cheese omelet bites. So check that out. All righty. So again, going back to our list here, there's our list tonight. And you can check those out as well. All right. Has anybody tried any of these? Let me just see if we got any feedback. Anybody tried any of these and want to recommend them? Just waiting to see here in the chat. Anybody tried any of these? I believe I've had the chicken and vegetable stir fry. Honestly, I don't eat these a lot. Frozen meals, fairly rare. So not that, you know, I'm better. I just usually have a chance to try other things. I'm on like this peanut butter and jelly sandwich kick lately. Sugar-free jelly. All right. Nobody's tried any of these? Okay. That's all right. Now let's talk about negative ones. So again, not as good as the negative twos and threes, but we could still do these in weight loss and be fine. So let me throw up one here. This is a good food made simple, turkey breakfast. So, and you might want to, on your list, again, mark these down. And maybe here's the other thing you could do on your list. You could make a Kroger breakfast list and just do it that way. So here's a Good Foods Made Simple. And this is a turkey breakfast bowl. So right here it is, turkey sausage breakfast bowl. So very good. So what we got in there? We got turkey sausage, little roasted potatoes. Ooh, little energy carb there, little fibrous carb, category two, category three, category two. Little bit of condiment in there. And obviously, so we got the turkey sausage. That's cool. So that's a good one. Now, another category that you, I think, does a great job are the Jimmy Dean, is the Jimmy Dean line, the Jimmy Dean Delights. Now, again, not every Jimmy Dean is going to be approved. And in this category, we're going to obviously be a lot more stringent here on the negative one, twos, and threes. But we do have these breakfast bowls that are out here as well. And I'm trying to see, I know I had it, it showed up earlier, and now I'm not seeing it on this one, but it's out there because I found it earlier because I researched all this stuff. Here's a turkey sausage one that works, breakfast bowl. Now I have had this one. Again, we've got category one, got category three. So that as well. So this one works again. And you say, Jim, why does some of this work? Because I'm looking at some of this stuff and it doesn't have like a normal combination. It doesn't have like a normal combination, Jim. So let me address that for a second. And I don't believe Kim gets into that in Fast Track as much, but there are other classes. And if you download phase one book, which you should do in Fast Track on day one, if you download phase one book, we talk about how we qualify meal replacements. There's a formula that we use here on Shibboleth. And so you're going to see sometimes in these, you're going to be like, well, there's a fatty protein and an energy carb in there and a fibrous carb. And how does that work? How come that works? And what you're telling me to put on my plate at home is different. Again, in a packaged product, there's a formula that we've used for years that works great. And these things meet our criteria. And there's sometimes a couple other things that are involved, like the ingredients that are used and how they break down in the body. So there's a couple other little factors, but there's a basic formula that we use. So again, that's why sometimes you might, if you're new, you might be scratching your head like, well, why does that work? Because that's not an exact combination we use. Yes. The combinations we teach you are safe and we know they're going to work for you. And so we're good. When we get into things like this, we have a formula. And again, download phase one book in the Fast Track and you can learn that formula. And I know Travis has got other classes on it as well. So check that out. There's also a farmhouse one. See if I can pull that, if that'll pull that up here for me. Right here, here is a Jimmy Dean Delights farmhouse breakfast bowl. So look at this, eggs, potatoes, onions, green and red peppers, cheddar cheese, turkey sausage, and portobello mushrooms. Woohoo! Man, I'm getting ready for breakfast. Well, I actually had breakfast for supper tonight. This sounded good. So that's another one. Here is another one. Let's see if we can pull this one up. It's not pulling that up, is it? See if it'll pull it up this way. Didn't pull that up. All right, I'll just pull the slide up here because I'm not pulling it up quickly and I don't want y'all to sit here and watch me type. Jimmy Dean Delights breakfast bowl, broccoli, cheese, and ham was what I was going for there. Jimmy Dean Delights breakfast bowl farmhouse, turkey sausage, and the breakfast wrap. Turkey sausage and veggie. So we've got bowls and we've got a wrap here. So these are negative ones on our fat loss meter, weight loss meter. And so that is, sorry, I'm having to try to look at the chat. So there you go. So we've covered so far negative threes, negative twos, negative one, frozen entrees that you can eat quickly that are really going to help you burn off the fat. But we got more. So let me show you another one. Here's some more. Here is another real good. Remember I showed you those enchiladas earlier? Well, this is the cheese version. So earlier I showed you the enchiladas that were the beef and pork. Those worked fine as a -2. These are a -3. So the cheese one. You say, well, why is it a negative? I mean, this is a -1, not a -2. And you say, well, how come these are a little bit lower? They don't have near the protein in them, just to be honest with you, is the main reason. But if you just like cheese enchiladas, you could do that with some red sauce. And again, if you don't know a real good, their foundational thing is chicken breast. So like real good pizzas have chicken breast as the foundation. These are chicken breast and cheese enchiladas. So they beat that poor chicken breast so it's thin and then use it like a tortilla. So there you go. There's another one here that's a -1. See if I can pull that up. It's a real good stuffed chicken. So check that one out. And broccoli and cheddar cheese stuffed chicken. Work. So very, very good. So check that one out as well. Also, let me ask a question. See how many of y'all know this. And if you're on Facebook, I don't know, people in Zoom room might beat you. That's why you need to get on Zoom. Who makes the Smart Ones line? Does anybody know? That's my trivia right now. Does anybody know who makes the Smart Ones? Waiting to see if anybody knows who makes the Smart One line. Who makes it? Yes, Weight Watchers. Valerie got it. Weight Watchers makes it. So there you go. We're going to take a look at them in a second, but I psyched you out because I forgot one more. We're going to get to them though. One more. Here is the Simple Truth line at Kroger, the All-American Omelet Bites. All-American Omelet Bites. So there you go. So super yummy. Filled with cheddar cheese, onion, hash browns, uncured bacon. So that looks good. Yeah, so Smart Ones is made by Weight Watchers. And let me show you a few out here that work. Slow roasted turkey breast works. This is a -1. On the weight loss meter. Here is another one that works. This sounds yummy. Creamy basil chicken with broccoli. So I like that creamy stuff. So, all right. Okay, let's see. Valerie said, I've had that and it's good. Okay, there you go. So again, don't want you to live off this stuff, but it's stuff you can keep in the freezer for a quick, hey, I don't have time to do something and grab it. Rather you eat this. I think that's a duplicate there. I'd rather you eat these than to sit there and have a piece of coconut cream pie and a piece of fried chicken and throw yourself out of efficient fat burn. Which, by the way, if you are looking for a challenge this month, Jason, one of our trainers, is doing a challenge called Efficient Fat Burn Challenge. So you can check that out. And that's happening this month here. So there is a picture of Jason. And so right here Wednesday, we've got Efficient Fat Burn Challenge, and I believe you can get a badge for that. So you might want to check that out as well. So just wanted to bring that to your attention. Okay, let's see, where are we at? All right, let's go down now to some more stuff. Hope you guys are getting some ideas. Again, add them to your grocery store list. Let's take a look at shakes. Meal replacement shakes. I have -2, so maybe there weren't any -3s out there. So maybe either that or I missed something. So we'll start with negative twos. These would work fine for you. Meal replacement shakes. Simple Truth, again, Kroger. They have a plant-based protein powder. And again, if you're like, well, Jim, how do I make that? Well, we can go out here to the website and we can pull it up on the website here. And it would let us know Simple Truth plant-based protein powder. Let's just take a look at that. I don't want to close that page. That's why I keep opening up new pages. So one scoop is a snack, up to two scoops is a meal replacement. So very healthy, plant-based. So you can check that one out. Let me give you another one that you could try. SlimFast. Now again, not every SlimFast is going to work, but if you like SlimFast, early, many years ago, before I started my lifestyle, when I tried to lose weight, probably 15 years ago, I think I went on a SlimFast kick and I quit pretty quickly. But here's the advanced energy protein shake, and you can do any flavor on these. Advanced, both of them work. There's an advanced nutrition, and there's also an advanced energy. So you can do the advanced nutrition or the advanced energy. So this might be one. And the reason this is energy is it's got caffeine in it. So you could do that. So check that one out. That could be a meal replacement. Another one, if you want to, by Garden of Life. And it's a raw organic protein, not Garden of Lift, Garden of Life. They have a plant-based thing. I can't find it right now, but it's out there because I found it earlier. There it is. Here it is, the plant-based protein powder. So again, would be a lot cleaner powder and would, so this is vegan, gluten-free, all that stuff. So it's great. Here is another one that would work. J. Rob, I haven't had his stuff in a long time. He's usually find his stuff like in a vitamin shop, but here is an egg white protein powder they carry at Kroger. J. Rob, so he's been around for a while. Another one that you will find at Kroger is Premier Protein. Premier Protein shakes, so you can check those out as well. Any flavor. Now there's on the website, we have the 23 gram. These are the 30 gram. So we recommend the 23 gram. So to check those out, I'm sure there's some down here or 20 gram. Here's some 20 grams. So you'd definitely be safe with that on that one. So check that out. Also one other, if you've tried these, are Quest. I eat Quest bars on occasion, and we'll talk about those in a minute. But Quest also has a protein powder as well. And so you can try out Quest. Has anybody tried the Quest products? Not just the protein powders, but the Quest products. Just curious. All right, some of y'all have. Yeah, Valerie has. Love the banana. Premier protein shake. Okay, good. I like to hear recommendations. I have not tried that. Lori says, yes, the bars. I found some people like the bars, some people don't. What's y'all's favorite bar on the Quest? There's a gas station down the street from my church. I usually pack something with me just for, well, I usually take lunch and it just depends. But sometimes, I don't know, some days I'm just like, I'm gonna go down there and get me a Quest bar. I had the raspberry cheesecake last week, double chocolate chips in the purple package. I haven't had that one. I've had the chocolate chip cookie dough. That's my favorite. And I think there's another chocolate one that I like. I haven't had the raspberry cheesecake. Again, some people love them, some people don't, but they have a protein powder. Has anybody tried the protein powder? I don't think I have done the protein powder. But there you go. Here is back to Atkins. Of course, Atkins has been around for a long time. So Atkins shakes will work. Has anybody tried the Atkins shakes? I probably have. It's just been forever. Some of their stuff I like, some of their stuff I don't. Of course, I definitely love the stuff we carry in the Shibboleth store. I ordered one of my favorite bars this week, a box of them. And I'll talk about them in a minute, actually. Here's another one, Core Power. These are made, the people that make the Fairlife milk make these. These are their protein shake, 26 grams of protein. So you can try that. Usually it's going to be over by the milks in the refrigerated section. Another one that works is the Muscle Milk Pro series. So here's the Pro series. You can use their protein powder if you want to do that. And they carry this at Kroger, Muscle Milk Pro series. And they have the shakes as well. All righty, let me check on Facebook. Somebody says, I love the Atkins Mocha Latte shakes. That sounds yummy. Peanut butter, Tammy, I assume that's on the Quest peanut butter. I think I've had that one. Premier protein shakes, yep. I've had a lot of people say they like the Premier protein shakes. I haven't tried those in a long time. I've tried the Premier bars. No, it's pure protein that I tried a long time ago. And I thought they had it's kind of really a word. I call it proteiny taste. They kind of had this protein, there's an aftertaste. And some products, they're a lot more pronounced than others. So I was like, yeah, I think there's better out there. In fact, I know there are better out there. Okay, so just put those up on the list here for you real quickly. And again, if you are in the Zoom room tonight, I will send you an email soon as I can. By the end of this week, you might get two or three of them in a row if you were in all the classes. I have one more tour on Thursday night at 7:30. Still at Kroger. We're going to be covering another category of food on Thursday night. Let me give you some more. I already told you those. J. Rob, Premier Protein, Pure Protein, Quest. Put those back up there in case somebody's feverishly writing them down. Let me check over here on the other machine. Oh, Power Crunch Bar. Yes, I love Power Crunch Bars, Polly. I don't think they carry those at Kroger. I could be wrong. I don't think I checked that one. So they may carry them. You know what? I think they do. They do carry Power Crunch at Kroger. I should have remembered that. I'm almost 100% certain they carry the Power Crunch Bars. I like the Power Crunch. That's one of my favorites. My wife's personal favorite is the Power Crunch Chocolat bars, and don't typically find those at Kroger. In fact, the only place I ever find the Chocolats are going to be at like a vitamin shop, or you can buy them on, guess where? Shibboleth. Here is my favorite Power Crunch bar. Right here, the Chocolats. These are awesome-o. These, the milk chocolate, tastes like a Nestle Crunch milk chocolate. You can buy it from us. And of course, the more you buy from us, it helps us, okay? So hey, if it's between us and Amazon, go for us, please support us. But the dark chocolate is awesome too. In fact, I meant to place them in my last order and somehow I didn't get them in my cart and my wife was sorely disappointed. So on the next order, which will probably be in the next week or so, I'm going to be getting some MCT oil, zero drag MCT, and probably a couple boxes of chocolate bars because those are an awesome snack. So I love those things. Now that I'm talking about them, I'm really missing them. But I do believe that we do have the Power Crunch R at Kroger. You type that in. There you go. So there are Power Crunches there at Kroger. I've had a few of these. They tend to carry the wafers. And I may eat my words. They may have a chalk lot down here, but I've never known them to carry the chalk lot there. So nope, these are all wafer bars. So you want to get the chalk lot from us. If you like Nestle Crunch bars, those are super awesome. All right, I told you I'd carry a few mixes tonight. And if you're looking for some breakfast ideas, quick breakfast ideas, the Birch Benders, things right here, the Keto, the Micro Pancakery Keto mix will work for you. And again, if you're like, well, Jim, how do I make that? Well, let's just go up here real quickly and always use the food library. And you're like, oh man, I don't have time to go to the food library, I want to make something. Hey, you do it once and you got it. So, you know, you look at it one time and say, okay, this is how I do it. So again, with egg whites, 2 4-inch pancakes as a plus one weight loss snack, right? We were talking as a meal. So this says 2 4-inch pancakes with egg whites or 2 ounces of another category one. Maybe you have that with a little bit of Kroger Cardmaster milk. That's category one lean protein as a negative one on the weight loss meter meal, or up to 3 pancakes as a zero. So there's lots of ways you can do that. And you can add 50 calories total in condiments. So a little bit of Walden Farms pancake syrup, which is actually pretty good. I like it. Not a fan of everything on Walden Farms, but again, that might be one, and check that out in the online store. Here is another one on the Birch Benders real quick. So the keto works. They also have a paleo version that works for us. So there's their paleo. See, I love it, because if I was on paleo, I'd be like, well, we'll eat paleo stuff. I can eat anything here on mine. And there's also a protein one that works as well. So we got 3 pancake mixes that we can do. Now, I'm going to tell you the truth. I have never used these because I am a huge fan of CarbQuick. Has anybody here used CarbQuick? I am a huge fan of CarbQuick. Love CarbQuick. I have been using CarbQuick for years, and we have that in our store. And you can, well, we should have it. There it is. CarbQuick in our store. Now you're like, oh my goodness, $25. Listen, that's a 3-pound box. And hey, special member pricing, 20. Woohoo! That's a 3-pound box. My 3-pound boxes last me 4 to 5 months. And I have pancakes and waffles fairly regularly. So lots of recipes and lots of ways you can use this as their negative one. They are a category 2. So that kind of looks weird. I'm gonna fix that so it looks better. They are category 2. So these are awesome. Anybody else had those? Yes, Valerie says, love it, make great biscuits. Right, you're not gonna find those. I think CarbQuick says they're at Walmart, but Kroger, but I have never seen them at Kroger. Let me show you a real quickly here. We're gonna wrap up. Travis and I were like, we're gonna do this class for about 45 minutes, and now they're turning into 1-hour classes, but as long as y'all are hanging with me, let me show you some -3 meal replacement bars. Now, I had these when they first came out. I was not a fan. I'm just being honest. Now, if anybody's tried a no-cal bar online and wants to put it in Facebook chat, I'll look over there. Or if anybody's tried these and you say they're yummy, then I will go with you. I had them when they first came out. They didn't look this way. It's a different wrap, and I was not impressed. But they, not only because of their nutritional numbers, but also because of their ingredients. So they're a very clean bar. Now, Quest bars, any flavor. So we were all talking about Quest, very good bar. That was my other one I was trying to think of, double chocolate crunch. That's one of my favorites. So pretty good and clean bar, not a lot of fillers and additives. So that's a super yummy one. I did not see any negative two bars in the on our website that were carried by Kroger. I could have missed them. Oh no, I did see one. I'm sorry. It was called Think. I have not tried this bar, but these were a negative two. Has anybody tried a Think bar? All right, Michelle says, I bought some but haven't used it yet. Oh no, Carquick, she's on my Carquick. I have not tried these. Now, occasionally when I go to Kroger, I'll get on a whim and I will just buy those there. By the way, just so you know, if you do all your shopping online right now, and you get a lot of stuff from Amazon. So I just got something from Amazon I'm super excited about. And when this class is over, I'm going to be working on a video because I bought me a Fitbit. I haven't done anything with it except charge it because I've been so busy all day. So that's my game tonight. But hey, if you can buy things, if you buy things through Amazon, then, you know, if you go to our store and it says find it on Amazon and you do shopping on Amazon, hey, click that button, because again, it just helps us a little bit when you buy it through us. Amazon recognizes that, and that makes them happy, makes them rich too. Let me show you a few others that you can do as well. And that is Atkins bars. Now Atkins bars are a negative one. Let me throw my slides back up here because I got way off, right? We already did the Atkins. I'm way off that. I got too excited about, we did mixes. I'll hopefully wrote those down. We did meal replacement bars. There was the No Cal and the Quest. We just looked at the Think. It was the only negative two that I found that Kroger had. Now y'all may find something else. Here's the negative ones back up to speed, Atkins bars. Now, let me just say this about Atkins bars. They are, and notice they are a negative one. They are a negative one. So you need to make sure that you know that. Now they are a cheaper bar, but they're not as clean as the other bars. They tend to have a lot of sugar alcohol in it, which again, if you eat a lot of sugar alcohol, it can cause a little gastric distress. Most people don't, it doesn't really bother them, but you know, again, we don't recommend you live on this stuff, but it's there for a quick thing. I mean, I'd be lying if I didn't tell you I didn't use these. Now, one of my favorites, this is what I bought from the Shibboleth store. Again, I could buy this at Kroger, but I'd rather buy it through Shibboleth, is the Robert Irvine bars. This is my favorite right here. This is my current favorite. Actually, my current favorite is, I like the peanut butter. They don't have my current favorite here. They do on the Shibboleth store. My current favorite is the chocolate chip cookie dough. That's been my favorite for a long time. The Robert Crunch, Robert Irvine, he did Restaurant Impossible and other shows. They actually had a talk show, didn't last, not surprising on that one. But anyways, these are super yummy. You can buy these in our online store. So I would get that from us. Love, love those bars. I'm kind of weird. I like to refrigerate mine and eat it chilled. It's really good. So, but I had one the other day. Saturday, I think I can't remember. I was on the road somewhere and I keep a couple in my car, especially when it's cold right now. Doesn't melt. So I call it a survival kit. And so I was on the road, didn't have time to stop at a restaurant. So I grabbed one. Hey, Jennifer likes hers chilled. All right. I'm not the only one. I like it chilled. I don't know why. Here's another brand that can work, Detour. Now you want to do the 32 gram ones. I'm not sure if this tells me which ones, 55 gram bars. So recommending the 32 gram bars here on our website. So check out Detour. I've had Detour, it's been a long time, but they were pretty good as well. Here's one last one. We're going to wrap it up with this. Fiber One, but not just any old Fiber One. Fiber One protein nut chewy bars. Just because it says Fiber One does not mean it's Shibboleth approved. So you need to make sure that, you know, you found it on the website in the food library, and I would just add it to your Kroger shopping list, and then you have that. So there you go, chewy. And these typically are a lot cheaper than maybe a Fit Crunch, but I don't think they're as good either. That's just my opinion. They don't have as much firepower either in them, but in a pinch, and there's been multiple times where I've just stopped at the old gas station and grabbed that. All right. Okay, well, if anybody's watching tonight and you're still thinking about Shibboleth, listen, you can be like Brittany, who's lost 90 pounds, or some of y'all who are getting started out. You're going to be up here one day. You're going to do this, all right? Alan's lost 70. So we have people melting all over the place. I love it when we melt because you just feel better. You'll feel better when you're melting. And you sleep better, and you don't have, hopefully you can get off medications. Are there any Kellogg's bars at work? Polly asked. Well, again, I like to go back to the website because I always like to double check myself, because I don't want to get say something that is wrong. And I do not see anything here on the website that says yes. So I do not see anything. But again, a great thing to do, Polly, is if you have a question, and we can always type in Kellogg just to see. I just want to show you guys how to maximize things here. We can type in Kellogg. I don't see any Kellogg bars listed. So I've got two options here. Let's go back out to survival tools. Again, you can just click that. You've got two options. I'll go back to food library. You got two options here. You could do a Kellogg bar and put it in the food calculator. Now, I will tell you, Kelly, start, if you're going to try one, start with, make sure it has protein in the name, because it's probably got a better chance of working. Again, Shibboleth is not a high protein program, but protein does have a huge role in thermic effect of food. And so we leverage protein. So if I were to check one out, we don't have any in the food library, I would start right here with something like this. This looks yummy. And I would start with this. Now, again, if you go to phase one and download the book, we get into the formulas. I don't think that's the purview of my class tonight to go teach you the formulas, but they are online. You can watch Travis teaching about that. But I would start here. And again, you could start by just putting these numbers in the food calculator, and that would be a good start. Now, if the food calculator says, well, then I wouldn't do it. If you're still like, I'm sure this has got to work, well, then you can go do another route and go back here to food library, and you could add a new food. Take a picture of the front and the back is the best. Take a picture of the nutrition label and the name of the brand, put it in here. And then you, if you can fill this out, if not, if you at least you have a picture of the nutrition label so that Kim can see it, and then go ahead and submit it. And then she will send you an email about whether it works or not. And if it does, hey, we will add it to the food library, because look at this, folks. We are always adding new things. These were recently added. So actually, here's one I didn't cover tonight. Kroger, light turkey, sausage, egg white, and cheese English muffin. So I didn't even put that in tonight's class. So I missed that one, right? So, here's why I didn't put it in tonight's class. It's a zero. Now again, you can eat zeros. I focused tonight just on -3, -2s, and -1s. So that's why I didn't put that one in there. It was a zero. But we're always adding stuff. So who knows? Something you might submit might get added. So maybe that'll answer your question. All right, see if there's anything on Facebook. Anything here in the Zoom room before we wrap it up tonight? I'm going to play with the Fitbit watch and get it synced up to Shibboleth. I'm going to try and make a little video on that as I go through the process. And we have a staff meeting at 9 o'clock at night. Shibboleth never sleeps. So we have a staff meeting in about 30 minutes. All right, anything before we head out? Hey, you're welcome, Valerie. Thank you. Thank you all for being here tonight in the Zoom room. Hey, it really encourages me when I have folks in here because I like talking to folks and chatting with you all, and glad to see everybody here, everybody on Facebook who watched us tonight as well. Again, I will get an email out to you hopefully in the next day or two with tonight's class. If you signed up for last night's class, you'll probably get an email for that. And if you join me on Thursday night, you'll get a class for that. Hey, Jennifer, you are welcome. Good job. Thanks. All right, everybody. Anything else? I don't want to end too early. All right. Glad you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to send me an email. Again, this is something new we're doing. So you can send it to jim.wright@myshibboleth.com. If you want to send me an email and ask, hey, I'd like to wonder about this, or I'd love to see this as a part of your grocery store tour. Hey, I'm always open to suggestions, or if there's anything that you have suggestions about anything else, I'd be glad to talk about that to everybody on the team and how we can improve, because we're always worrying, always, how can we make things better? How can we be the best at what we do? So that is why we meet at 9 o'clock at night, because everybody's busy. So, all right, everybody, thank you all so much for joining me. I am going to play with my new little toy here, and then I will see you hopefully Thursday night or tomorrow prayer time at 10 o'clock. God bless you all. Let's have a perfect day tomorrow. Hope everybody had a perfect day today. If you did not, then let's have one tomorrow. Let's have perfect days. Let's blowtorch that fat off our bodies. Okay, everybody, have a perfect day. Bye.